So the other problem that we talk about in here is this kind of like where we just find a general form of the derivative, what we actually get to the derivative. Okay. So when I go, there's usually, and like your book will use the phrase four-step process. I will use this, find the limit definition. And so it says and asks you to find f prime of x, and sometimes asks you to find f prime at a number. So let's do this example. Okay, for the one that we just did. Actually, let me give you a different, let's do f of x is equal to 3x minus 7. Okay, so I have these quantities. So the limit definition of the derivative, limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. Okay, and this is f prime of x is equal to this thing. Okay, so my first step, and like your book separates this out. So like I will find f of x plus h over here. So 3 times x plus h minus 7. This is 3x plus 3h minus 7. And then you come back over here and you'll find this. Let's put this in. Limit as h goes to 0. And here's 3x plus 3h minus 7. Now look, this is just this first part. I still have to subtract this second part, which is f of x, but I have f of x right here, 3x minus 7. Okay, that's the second part. See those two green brackets? You need two parts, and you need this big subtraction sign in there. And then all divided by h. Okay, now remember to distribute this subtraction. 3x minus 7 minus 3x plus 7 all over h. Okay? Look, it's a miracle. This 3x cancels this one. 7 cancels this one. Oh, wait. What happened to this? Oh, look, look, look. There's a 3x, but I mistakenly, let's put this 3h in there. Do you see how that's not there? This one did not come down. I need an h right there. Okay, good. Glad we caught that. That would have been confusing. Limit h goes to 0, 3h over h. The h's cancel. Limit as h goes to 0 of just the number 3. If there's no h's in there, I can let h do whatever I want, and I still get 3. So the derivative of this function is 3. And if you remember the shortcut method for derivatives, you will be able to check that too. Okay? Okay, and if you don't, we'll learn them in the next lesson. So no worries. Okay, I want to do one more example where we have a quadratic and where you find the definition using this definition. So find, oh, and this will be better. Yeah, f prime of x for f of x is equal to, let's say, 3x squared plus 2. Okay? Using the limit definition. Let's use my language, or the four-step process. Okay. So now we have f prime of x. I go back to this is the definition. Limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. Okay? And I might come over here and do, well, what's f of x plus h? This is usually the most complex part of this quantity. So this is why you'll see it broken out separately. Plus 2. f of x plus h squared plus 2. Okay, so I put that in there. I'm going to FOIL this out and leave the 3 out front. So in parentheses still, I'm going to get x squared plus 2xh plus h squared plus 2. That's an h squared. Then distribute the 3, so I'll get 3x squared plus 6xh plus 3h squared plus 2. Okay, now I'm going to go back over here and put that in. Again, this is just this first top left piece. 3x squared plus 6xh plus 3h squared plus 2. That's this piece is this one. Then I subtract minus, f of x. Okay, hold on. I'm going to put that right down here. Okay, look, I'm going to do it in a different color, but it's right here. F of x is back this one, right? Minus 3, I'm going to write it x squared plus 2, real small. Okay, hold on, I'm going to draw this box so that we know what goes where. Okay, because I'm running out of room. All over h. Don't forget this denominator. Okay. So go here and distribute this subtraction sign. So I get 3x squared plus 6xh plus 3h squared plus 2 minus 3x squared minus 2 all over h. Now look here, I have this 3x squared matches with this and will cancel or subtract. This 2 and this 2 cancel and I'm left with the limit as h goes to 0, 6xh plus 3h squared over h. This is the limit as h goes to 0 of h times 6x plus 3h over h. Those then cancel. Now, and I'm left with the limit as h goes to 0 of 6x plus 3h. And here the limit actually matters, right? I'm going to 0. This goes to 0, and so I get 6x as this limit, because 3 times 0 is 0. This is the derivative. Derivative, right? Also the slope of the tangent line. Also the instantaneous rate of change. And if I wanted to find f prime of 1, I just take 1 and plug it into 6x. So I get 6 times 1 is equal to 6. Okay? Okay. So in the next videos, we'll talk about just how to use shortcut methods. But this general idea, the thing that we need to keep in mind as we're working with the derivative, is that it comes from this idea of the secant line, where I'm moving these two red dots together and kind of getting an idea of slope or how things are changing. It's one of the most fundamental concepts we'll talk about in this class. Okay, let me know if you have questions.